Once again, I greet dear friends, and I would love you guys to pay attention to what I'm about to say. It is not a strange by us. We know whom they are, and we know their mission. But I want to specify exactly what they came for and what they are doing right now. The name of the operation, the code name of the operation, is 3567.
All right.
Am I coming out clear?
3567. All right.
3567, that is the code of operation they came. I don't know why I'm trying to figure out. I know 67 was when the first war was fought. So, and the British have their hands, and if not even only hands, their whole body into that war. So they came with that, the code of that operation, the one the head of armed forces came, is 3567. I am speaking from the highest intelligence network, and the reason of they have studied our activities, and they hear our people. All I can tell, and I'm using this opportunity to pass the message to our leader, because I couldn't get hold of him. It's just we when we are fighting a battle, we don't have to show our enemies their loopholes. If we show them their loopholes, they will go and fix it. I would love him to just look at the loopholes, their loopholes, and leave it there. And we don't tell them where their liabilities are. And we don't even show them their assets. We just leave them so that definitely they will come up and they manifest so that we can take advantage of their loopholes. If I'm engaging you on a battle, I'm not going to tell you your weak points. I will keep quiet. Why I'm saying this is because I've been into boxing. Before you take, let's say, Muhammad Ali and Larry Holmes, those days when Ali was fighting, Ali will go and watch Larry Holmes fight and watch him to see where his weak points are and where his strength lies. So, and when he gets into the ring, he will now play on that weak point and take advantage of that weak point to do or to defeat the enemy, either Larry Holmes or who is Sugar Ray Leonard or Marvin Marvelous Hagler. Remember those fighters in those days. Some of them are passed. And this is how he came up and said that he was the greatest. Cassius Clay said, "I am the greatest." Why? Because he will play it and give them his body to punch. So, because to be a good boxer, you have to be a good receiver. Know how to receive the punches, and don't show your enemy the areas where it pains you most. You see? So, when you show your enemies where it hurts you most, that is where he will be throwing punches at constantly until you give up. If you notice that you don't take punches on your body, he will give it to your body because you are shielding your head. You are shielding your head. So we give it to get weaker. Then you start covering your body and you leave your head vulnerable. Then a quick punch at a very spot that lies on your ears or in your ears, that the membrane, the thing that controls your bowel fluid. If I can get to that fluid and turn it around, you will go dizzy and go down. You see? So now boxing, I took the same thing to what we are doing and everything that I do in life. There is something that they call weak assets and liability. So sometimes we just leave them and keep it dark or darken it so that they don't know what is coming for them. I know that our leader is very kind. He doesn't want this thing to go this way. And I have my resentment, I must be honest. But sometimes, because of what I listen to a program, and I hear one sister pleading, say, "Drop every feelings, whatever you have. It is not the time to go into this thing, but come on board. Drop every feelings." Every Biafran must know that there is war. Every Biafran all over the world must know that there is war right now. The war has already begun, but we don't see it. Only when we want to see explosive taking exploding here and there, blowing off here and there, and the armored tanks flying our helicopter and all those stuff, you say, yes, there is war. This war has been going on for a very long time, and our people don't know. They come and in the public and speak like butterfly, but they sting like bees. That's what it is all about. So going back to the visitation of the armed forces. Armed forces didn't come there to play games. What they came to is to that I got it on that on intelligence network that they came for Operation 3567. I don't know what that means, but I'm looking into it. And what they came for, they now see that going through some certain areas like the Middle Belt, we hamper them and cause them. So what they want to do is to strategize and set up base or different in different locations. That is what they want. That is what that man came there to do. Set up base in different location and use a man, call it drum or whatever, to go and strike. That is what that man came for to do. And our people sometimes, that's why I think, to me personally, if I discover that you are very hardened and you are very ever going out to kill, I will shut my mouth and deal with that person. So anything I say, anything I do, you will not know how and who did it. You see, we have come to that particular point in time right now that every Biafran, those that are very good in throwing things on the social media, I will advise, suggest. I'm not going to advise you because you say, you ask me, who are you to advise me? I will suggest that you minimize all that you are showcasing. Let everything go underground, operation underground, and we will get this thing sorted out. They can come with anything, a man, aircraft, drone, whatever they want to import or bring or install in our system, in our areas. But once those things are located, we're going to, and that is what it is. Like our leader said yesterday in his interview, he said that this thing they are looking for, if they go further, every living thing in Nigeria will die. I will paraphrase on that. I've said it so many times. British government and their forces should pay very clear, close attention. You might be looking at a certain people, you look at them, you underrate them and underestimate them. You say they are nobody. We repeat that thing we did before. I suggest that they tread very carefully now. Just they tread very carefully. Mazindewo.
Thank you very much, Mazi. Like I said earlier on, I really, really want to exhaust all of this question if time will permit it. Now, the second one I want to go. You know, almost at the end of the broadcast or the interview that our leader grants, this leader, your people, you know, the reason I'm trying to, I was trying all I can to line this question to suit it one after the other as I'm asking the question. So, actually, I'm asking it based on what is happening on ground. So, this lady asks our leader, your people are killing people. What do you have to say about that? Please.
You see, this is, let me go to that particular woman. When I listen to her accent, she sounds like someone from Southern Africa. Could be South Africa or Zimbabwe. They have a similar accent. So I listened to her. And when all of a sudden I saw pictures of this woman coming out with Buhari and Dangote. I don't know if you have seen that on Facebook.
Trending. Yes, I do.
Yes. So you can see where they are coming from. I'm not going to judge her profession with her private life because she's into journalism. So a journalist can appear with anybody and take photograph. Yes. But it is quite convincing that she's with Dangote and with Buhari on a photograph. We know whom Dangote is and who we know who Buhari is. or worse. We know whom they are. So Dangote is the one monopolizing the commercial sector of the contraption called Nigeria, who has every license to import everything. And some of those things, our people have been doing it, but they want to transfer the wealth of that region or the regions
into their pockets.
Three regions that I know of. One person is in control of everything, and she was in photograph with that, knocked everything off. If you are a leader, that's what I keep telling our people. If you are a leader, every time I say something will happen to confirm what I'm saying. If you are a leader, imagine the former president of America standing with in a photograph with Bin Laden. How will America see it?
No, but that might be a bono.
How will America? Oh, but that might be a bono. Now, she said that they had that our. She said that she had that. She saw that our people are killing Nigerians. Is that correct?
Oh,
that's
yes.
What she was saying.
Mm-hmm.
And her network was very poor. Yesterday, it was very poor network. Let me say this. It is this media propaganda that we have been talking about. I hope I'm coming out clear, sir.
Yes, you are coming out wonderfully.
It is the media propaganda that we have been talking about. For many years, they have been killing Biafrans. The Fulanese have been killing, they have been killing Biafrans. Since 1945, or even from the beginning of the founding of the amalgamation, they spotted out that Biafrans are very resilient, hardworking, creative, innovative, and whatever good characteristic you can figure out in a human. We have it. That is why Ahmadu Bello said, when you put them in a labor job, all of a sudden he will emerge to be the leader. Why? Because he works very hard. He's very punctual. He doesn't come late. He's very dedicated to his job. So why wouldn't the director of the company promote him? He will promote him, of course. So now, to them, it is domineering. Being intelligent is domineering. Being hardworking is domineering. So as a result, they began to kill our people. Kill our people to minimize or to reduce the population. If they spot you out and they figure out that you have something in your brain, they will eliminate you. Now our people, all the years that they have been killing our people, this woman didn't see it. She didn't see it like other media platform, mainstream media. They never reported the massacring of Biafran 67 to 70. They never reported that.
No.
They never said that. The genocide, they never mentioned that. All of a sudden, because the tide is turning around now, our leader gave a command that if you kill anybody, we back.
Of course.
And they now see the handwriting on the wall that these people have the capability of carrying out such operation. Now they change. Oh, why are you killing them? This is genesis. We haven't started yet. We haven't started. This is the beginning. I believe that woman is. I am glad that I know that southern hemisphere, they are listening to Radio Biafra. They know who Maz is. They know what we are talking about. But because of the Fulanese bribery and all those stuff, false investment, and they will now keep quiet. I'm glad they're listening. But our leader made it very clear yesterday. He said, this thing they're looking for, this thing British is looking for, when that thing come to a push, every living...
All right.
It is never... He wasn't drunk when he was saying it. But let me leave it there and there.
All right, Mazi. Also, I wish we'll have enough time. But whatever the case may be, I will still do it. All right. And the next one, this lady say that our leader is spending people's money and nothing is moving. I was just like, he said that our leader is spending people's money and nothing. Can you throw light into that also?
Of course, I will. I got upset when I heard that. Let me say this. Which people was she talking about? communicated to her?
Of course, people he's talking about. This is exactly what he asked her to ask our leader.
Hold on, sir. I am not asking you to comment. I'm just juggling your mind.
Right.
I want you to see what is happening. Which people is she talking about? Did the Biafran people ever wrote that woman that our leader is eating whatever money? Did Biafran people wrote a letter to her? She is always listening to these idiots that are talking on online social media. They have not contributed any dime to the struggle. Our leader didn't want to make it clearer to this woman, but let us do it. They have not contributed any dime to the struggle. And the people who are giving are not complaining, because last time I checked, Saturday, a lot of people gave money all around the world. You understand? They are not complaining. And because she had it from Nigerian government, from the saboteurs who are busy feeding the Nigerian government, wanting to demoralize people. So, in order to kind of say, our leader, each time our leader wears suit, they say, he is eating the people, the contribution money. If he wears shoes, he's eating the money contributed for the struggle. Which these people are hopeless. I don't even expect, for that reason, I don't normally, like when people were attacking our brother Dele Momudo, our friend, I said, do not attack the man, he was doing his job. And now when I have respect for journalists, because they set their heads in some certain places, but this one is like, I'm glad that she brought it up for our leader to clear that atmosphere, that nothing like that is happening. I mean, take it or leave it. Before our leader came to establish IPOB, was he a destitute? Was he a beggar? Have you seen him where he carried a plate and put it on the street in United Kingdom and said, "Biko Nyerano Maka, help me out"? This is something that I can't understand. If you like somebody to a certain degree, I will not go into common sense. Will let me know. We are eating on the table before you establish this. You have vision and plan before you establish this. I will put myself in his situation too. Let's say somebody tomorrow come and say, they took our money and ate our money. I will take the person like this. I will show you my bank account. If you see, I will show you my bank account, my account statement. If we are giga. Our leader, that because everybody have their own because the jealousy has come to a certain level. No man is perfect. It has come to a certain level that I can't understand. This even woman went for that. This woman went for that to say, people coming out from places saying they are freedom fighters. They are freedom fighters. They're not passing by question, but this thing just, it was boiling me. I said, our leader gave a difference. He mentioned IFP. Remember, IFP was fighting even ANC when the struggle was going on in South Africa. UDM, General Bantu Holomisa, was fighting as well. The DA, Democratic Alliance, was there too. They have their own agenda. And so many PAC, Pan-Africa, that we are fighting, led by late Clarence Makweto. He was fighting. Talk about this Africana spokesman, led by Constant Falloon, was asking for homeland in South Africa. That homeland will be separate from South Africa. Constant Falloon, of course, go to the East. And I want to support our leader so that they can pass the message to the woman. There are many people coming up for liberation of Biafra. Asare Dokubo all of a sudden started talking of Biafra. But we know whom our leader gave that statement. He said, the people know their leader and they follow. When he gives order, they will follow. When you ask me, on the section of him fighting from foreign country that is living in a foreign country. I know it was Nigeria that posted to her. Mazi Ndewo.
Thank go for that, we answer you. Thank you very much, Mazi. All right, I still have yet another one, but this time I'm going to merge two questions together. Now, this woman also asked and say, why are you castigating the white, but you are living in their homeland? Are you not ashamed? One. And the second one, he said, how are you comfortable living in the UK in all that is happening in Falland or in Imo State? This is the two questions that I want to match together. Please, take it from here.
Okay. Let me. I saw that question. I wish I when I had it. Where are you now? Where is she? Where is the woman? She's in Germany, so to say. Of course, either by or through immigration, she got her status and began to live. He left. Let me use the word Nigeria. He said, I will go in the street of Nigeria, I will preach. He said he preached in at the airport. When he landed, he preached at the airport. He preached what? Biafra.
Of course.
He preached Biafra. Okay. Then he went to his hotel and he was abducted and taken to Kuje, taken to underground DSSL where they kept him. They kept him on that underground. How did Biafra know that Mazi Nnamdi Kanu abducted and DSS underground dungeon? That's where they violated every law, every known law set up, constitutional law governing nations. They violated it because they don't want to hear the truth. Mazi Nnamdi did not to foreign country just because when he came he was in foreign country to study. Everyone did that. Oliver Tambo spent his life in United Kingdom. He was spearheading. He was in UK fighting. He didn't enjoy fresh weather and democracy and stability of economy. Not at all. He never forgot his people. A lot of South Africans were overseas fighting. They never slept. This woman, Felicia Mabuza Soto Show, the one that used to have America, married American, but she forgot South Africa. That we are fighting from foreign countries, even Mama Africa. So we can go, you can't change the narrative. Because Nnamdi Kanu's own be different. He came to study in United Kingdom. After his career, after the study, he went into his career. He was there before the call came, and he began to answer the call. When he came, he said he will preach everywhere. He wasn't afraid. He had an example. I cannot, even there, if there is anything that I don't agree with our leader, I can make it the truth to everyone. And he came, we did what made him to leave the country? What made him fled the country? And assassinate him. They assassinated wrong people, ordinary people, people walking on the street. Killed every killable thing there and denied that they never did anything of such. Left by his fine grace of Elohim, he managed to escape there and found himself in foreign country and countries and eventually. The question is, would you stand empty-handed to fight somebody with AK-47 and armored tanker? How can somebody be so stupid and naive to face someone with AK-47 while you don't have anything? So the best thing that you can do, I will use escape velocity. Escape velocity. Velocity is what makes aircraft fly. So for such that doesn't know what I'm talking about, you can escape. When you escape, then you can mount strategy from where you are. Wherever you are based, in the place where he is, because in that place is a white. Yeah, you most of us are living in countries that we are not comfortable in foreign countries. The necessity is the mother of invention. When things can no longer hold together, things will fall apart. So you can devise every method in order for you to be safeguarded and the family as well. Didn't they kill the mother, the father, as a result of that? Who will see where they killed so many people who have trauma? Tell me who will see where one person in front of not traumatized. Trauma is this. Let me explain. If you go and rape a woman, she survived that rape. She survived physically, but you killed her, a dead person. Okay. That's why rape is the biggest crime. And even of. So if you rape somebody, you really literally kill that person, because her life will never remain the same anymore. You violated the person. Our leader was vilification. That's what happened there. And people, we leave substance and start running after shadow. When I hear paid journalists, I laugh at their ignorance and their stupidity, even to their career. Their career. They come up and paint white, black, and black, white, and say, "Oh, I just got him now. He's enjoying a European country. He hated white man. Imagine now the Kanu never. He hated white man and gave a white man the control of UK family. Can you imagine what I'm saying here?
Oh yes.
He hated white man, and the 1+1, people will say, but the woman submits to the man. The man is the UK family national coordinator. That's what I heard. I have my own conduct. I'm not public. Yeah, but I believe personally. I believe the kingdom is made for the citizen of that kingdom to appreciate the gospel of Biafra. Him, that's why he never allowed angel to preach. The angels are not allowed to deliver the message of salvation, because angels were never fallen before those in Elohim. As angel can never say, once I was lost and now I am found. And that's why in the book of Acts chapter 10, he sent an angel, a soul doing the right thing, said, go and talk to Peter. Send for a man, he will come and tell you what you must do. Capital, you can't talk to Colenius about the fallen nature of man. Peter will do that for him. So I believe a white man, anything but a white man, a white man can be, but he can't talk to me about that when I'm around. Mazi Ndewo. Ndewo.
Mazi, when you woke up this morning, I hope that angel will come and touch you somewhere where you smile.
Let me tell you, I love our leader. I love any best thing you can wish in life, I wish him the best in life. I love him. But I'm holding a sword. And that sword is two-edged sword. One is for any price for this struggle. I am assuring every Biafran listening to me.
Thank you.
I want him to achieve everything. I want him to deliver. That's what my mission is. And then we'll go ahead.
All right. Thank you very much. It's just like this show, the interview was just made for this show, I must be honest with you. So, one, I just want to put my personal, how will I put it into words? Personal experience. I just want to say it before I ask the next question. Me, person, and I'm no longer a kid. Right from the end of my life up until now, I have not been in any association of whatever, name it, or association of Ndibu or whatever. Once, only once in my life that I went with my parents to ending of the year meeting. That you know how they celebrate this meet, ending of the year, and this was in Lagos. That was my life only once. Apart from that, I have not been in any meeting. I have not been in any association. Name it, whatever name it is, name it. I have not been in them, and I don't want to be. Still. Now, the reason why I said what I said was, some of us may understand why I said it, some of us will not understand. But I will ask this question, then you will understand. This lady asked our leader, and she said, how can you be clamoring for Biafra, whereas there is no unity among you Biafrans? Mazi, what do you have to say about this one?
I will answer her. When she said that, I said in my mind, I said to myself, how the cause of who told there is no, who told, just like what God told him, naked. Can only go again in water. Did I tell you are naked? It was what the serpent made Adam to experience. And Adam experienced what he asked for, and Elohim came. He said, where are you? He said, I heard your voice and went and hid myself because I am naked. Elohim didn't say, where are you hiding? No. He said, first of all, he corrected his statement. I told you that you are naked. But one or no, an Atorak is there. You understand? And the woman always want to say, the reason why this man went to not having anybody following them, because they want to play this narrative to the foreign powers. Don't give it to them that we ever, that we always together, they are divided. Who, tell me the leader of Africa, any leader, past and present, that ever we stay in an exile. We are all in exile. I am in exile. Our leader is in exile. We are exiling it anywhere we are located. From my location, I'm in exile. I have been in exile for many years. I have never wanted the glory that comes from Zoo. Even when you guys didn't see anything, I saw a lot of things because I've been an insider. I know what I've been doing. So there was injustice, there was inequality, there was this segregation, there is tribalism, there is ethnocentrism, everything. So she now come up to say, we are not united. But I went last time I checked, and never seen any from exile, and the people at home begin to talk. Our leader have called it at home several times. I can't count it. Even the deputy under the command of our leader, the people obey the former deputy Ushemefo. Not because of Ushemefo, they obeyed because of he was speaking from the platform of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. That is why our people, if you come in the name of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, you ask for in Biafra, you will get it to give it to you. That is what criminals are taking and using it to go and defraud our people. Haven't you had it? And instead, no collection of this from this particular state. Why? Because they are using the name that is given to mankind, to Biafran. Under this name, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, you will get what you are looking for. I might be angry. My anger cannot change the narrative. It's a fact. Brothers and sisters, it's a fact. God gave him this opportunity. All my prayer is for him to do the needful. I know he will. You understand?
Yeah.
And if you look at the history, it has never been Ojukwu fought, yes, but not totally like our leader is doing it. Now they see everything. They said different. They created them. Sorry, sir, I'm almost done. They created different people so they can use it. Oh, they are divided. They are not together. Who told them that we are not together?
Thank you very much. I still have two more, and I'm looking at the time. God will help us. All right. Again, here he says,
don't push it. I will rush it. Don't.
All right. He says, yeah. I don't know. I woke up today. I was so happy. I don't know. And with all of these things that I'm seeing here, you know, I can't help myself but to laugh. You know, that is the reason why I used to say to people, when you woke up in the morning, the best medicine you can take is just even if there is nothing, you know, nothing that will even if you don't know it, start laughing. You know, equation. You know, Obiana, by so I'm going to ask one again. He says, yeah, she is asking our leader if it is about leadership or the freedom of Biafran people. What is it? Exactly. Anything to say about this one?
Oh, yes. Look at what they have been painting to foreign countries. To even some of, I have someone, have a family member who married Buhari's relative. I'm not going to lie to you. But the money is who is Aga. Oga no siri Aga. She came to tell me that we are, and I was Fulani, but I'm not going to know Fulani. No, I shall say, and I was happy to go to somebody. So you, when I have a, you not stop into someone else. They want to make you play it that they have been sending these messages to all the diplomatic world that these people want power. She asked the question, people want position or you want liberation. I had it, I had that clear. The same thing happened in everywhere. It happened in South Africa as well. And we keep on hammering there because she's from Southern Hemisphere. Everybody knows ANC saga. When it took off, all of a sudden, Buthelezi started talking. All of a sudden, what is his name? General Bantu Holomisa started talking. Of course, I respect them. Constant Folion started talking. He wants Volkstaat, the free state, independent state, for white South African in South Africa, that you will use visa to go there. Imagine. All this confusion came. Which one is worse than that? But when you do a survey, what they call survey, or call it referendum, you will find out that every Biafran is in accord, is concurring with what Mazin Nnamdi Kanu is saying. Every Biafran is IPOB. Forget what Asarede Okubo and the rest are talking about. They set them up so that they can draw this narrative. That's why they broke away and they started talking rubbish, including Ushemefa and his cohorts, to make it look like these people want power. Who want? No one wants power. I want liberation. I want our nation to be liberated. I want whom, if as not whomever, God is using Mazin Nnamdi Kanu as he pays attention to Elohim. He will deliver that message clean, clear, and everybody will be liberated. As Sarah Dokobo doesn't have command over Biafrans. No, but even he doesn't have command over his job family. He can't. His job people, they know whom he is. He works for Nigerian government. He guards their pipelines. And Ushemefo, no, but everybody knows what Ushemefo has been craving for. I have said it repeatedly. He has witnessed. I cannot lie. If I lie, I die. They can call me names. I don't mind. But anytime you consult me, I will tell you the truth. I tell you what is going on. For those that doesn't know, they are very short-sighted and short-minded, very myopic. They want instant gratification. They want it now. They don't see tomorrow. They don't see many years ahead. They don't see the generation coming. They don't know how the future of Biafrans will look like under Nigeria in the next 10, 50 years. They don't know about it. And somebody that God opened his eyes and his mind to see the future came and was telling us, no matter whatever he's doing, I will never blame him. I said it in my privacy, and I will say it publicly. I will never be mad to a certain level that I was pushed, but I said no. Restraint came from Elohim.
Dalo Rinne. All right, I have the last one here, and this one, you know, I don't know what you're going to say about this one, even though you listened to the interview, but I don't know what you will say about this one. Now, the lady asked and said, original Buhari Original Buhari and the fake Buhari, which one is more better? Do you have anything to say about this one?
I laughed. When I heard it, I laughed. Obviously, the word of God said, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Buhari is dead and that Elohim is the Lord and the Nna and the Kano is the leader.
Mazi, hold on.
Obviously, there are...
I want to interrupt you, Mazi. Please, can you give us the verse of this quotation that you just gave us?
Please. Come again.
Please, can you give us the quotation or the verses of this? You know, I don't know. Where did you get this one from?
The word of God says that the word of God says in the holy book that every knee shall bow.
Okay.
And every tongue shall confess that Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is sent by Elohim. But if you go to the original quotation, it said every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that.
Oh yes.
That Nnamdi Kanu is Lord over Biafra. My prayer is for him to stay under the covering of Elohim 24/7, not being afraid. And I believe that Elohim will do it.
Oh, yes.
My ever prayer is for him to deliver, hands down to deliver. You know, when they started talking about the version, there are many versions of Buhari. They had it. All the dignitaries will pass the messages. South African government knows that person is not Buhari. He was there. And people, Biafran showed up there. He was in so many countries, Biafran showed up there. When he came to UK, to London, Biafran was there. They were all there. Even Nigerians came. Reno Omokri was saying something. He said people should go there and disturb the idiot. They wore him mask. And everyone knows, just to confuse little idiots, they called black monkeys in that contraption, niggas. They wore him mask, say the niggas will never find out. And especially in that region, who has been given the problem from the beginning, came out and said, through our leader, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, he said, the reason why they are doing this thing is to shut me up. The person you are looking at in Aso Rock is not Buhari, for Buhari is dead. Gave the flight details. I mean, the intelligence was very specific. Gave the flight details, the flight that went, transited in Morocco, looking for oxygen, and they couldn't make it. And when you don't have sufficient oxygen in your brain, the person will be brain dead. That will lead to total death of the body. And he died before arriving to UK. And they couldn't handle it. They were confused. They said, again, Osoba. And they said, what can we do now? Yara Dua died here. This one died here. How can we do? Okay, you know what? If we can play this, we will give you people a mask. Somebody that look like him, we would use the face and do some technical, things and put something in his voice and it would sound like him. And when he came out, he said he couldn't speak his language again. That the particular brain that controls the language has been cut off. These people are mad people. And he couldn't speak Fufude. And he came out becoming shorter than his normal height. Everybody who knows Buhari from Katsina knows that Buhari is tall. The Buhari that we know about, he was a tall man. And he hardly could pray because he has problem in bending down and standing up and hitting his head on the ground. So everybody call him a lazy Buhari. Long ago, secretly, almost military officers called him, Muslims call him lazy Buhari who can pray. So that is the man. I know about that theory. It is a fact. If not, what stopped them from bringing somebody, conduct interview in Fufude language? And different people will bombard it. They don't even know anything there. And all of a sudden, they are channeling every investment, the money of the Pierre France to Niger Republic.